The Namibia President Hage Geingob arrived in the country this morning and held bilateral talks with President Uhuru Kenyatta. President Kenyatta expressed satisfaction that the foreign ministers of Kenya and Namibia have remained engaged in the last 3 months, leading to the inauguration of the Joint Commission for Cooperation, which has been dormant for close to 2 decades.
We have continued to strengthen the ties of friendship and brotherhood that have underpinned and have been underpinned by shared values, aspirations, and a resolute commitment to continental integration and also to uniting our people.
Now, Ethiopian Airlines coming there, the tourism that we both depend on is from Kenya to link from Kenya to Namibia, and regional tourism. And that's one area.
Speaking after the signing of the agreements, the two heads of state acknowledge the two countries share similar aspirations and challenges and can draw from each other's experience to complement the expertise and the comparative advantage of each country. President Kenyatta urged Namibia to explore the possibility of engagement in new areas, including cooperation in marine and fisheries development, mining, expansion of bilateral trade and investment, and in sports and culture. The two leaders also engaged in strengthening cooperation in health sector with enhanced transfer exchange of health workers. President Kenyatta commended President Geingob's transformational and visionary economic agenda under the Harambee Prosperity Plan, saying it resonates well with Kenya's Big Four agenda.
Your Excellency, I'd also like to take this opportunity to express my salutations to you on your assumption of the chairmanship of the Southern African Development Corporation, SADC, earlier this year in August. And I am confident that your strong leadership credentials, principled commitment to regional and continental economic integration, puts you in good stead to steer the organization's developmental aspirations for continued stability and prosperity, not just of the SADC region, but of the continent as a whole.
Meanwhile, two young innovators, Shalin Nafula and Evans Wadongo, are among the 468 passengers flying to New York during the historic Kenya Airways inaugural direct flight to New York on October 28th. Speaking while handing them tickets, State House spokesperson Kanze Dena said the two entrepreneurs were selected under the big picture of President Kenyatta's efforts to unite and uplift the youth. Kevin Washira, Channel One News.